Welcome back to MacBreak Studio. I'm Mark, I'm with Steve. We're talking about, actually, I don't know what we're talking about because Steve kind of left me in the dark. So what are we doing here?
Well, stock footage. I use a lot of stock footage. Well, I don't use a lot of it, but when I do, I need to find it. And you know, a lot of people, when they do use stock, they put it in their timeline, they use different stock libraries, and at the end, they need to replace it because it has a watermark.
Yeah, but you don't know where it came. You know where it came from, if it was Pond5 or whatever, but you don't know where on that site it came from if you didn't save it with the correct little 16-digit number or something.
And a lot of times, that's not even correct.
Yes.
Yeah. So
yes.
I found this next trick is just fantastic, and it not only works with stock footage, it works with stock audio as well.
And you mentioned that somebody told you about this.
Right, Anders Utterstrom from, I hope I pronounced that right, from Chicago, and he gets all the credit for this, but it's a lot of fun.
Okay, let's take a look at it.
You bet. One of my favorite stock sites is, of course, Pond5. It's the largest site out there, and this is a clip that I wanted a preview for, and most of these sites allow you to download a preview, a watermark.
Yes.
In this case, big Pond5.
It's very clear where that came from.
Okay, some are a little less, a little more subtle than that.
Uh-huh.
But there you have it. So I'm going to go back to Final Cut and show you that I've got this time lapse project, and let's say I was working on this for a client. I'm my own client because I did this. But let's say this is a, you know, something for network or broadcast or what have you, and I have a lot of stuff from San Francisco here. I've got these Golden Gate Bridge shots, but I needed another Golden Gate Bridge shot, so I didn't want to go out and shoot it. And really, I'm not going to fly my drone over the Golden Gate Bridge. I don't even know if that, with the legality.
Well, somebody did recently, just a couple weeks ago, they posted some beautiful footage. I don't know how they did it, but they flew a drone all over the bridge.
Be like FAA probably.
I don't know. But anyway, it would be a big thing to go out and do that.
Right.
And you can go buy it.
All right. So here it is. I think that's a pretty awesome shot. Bottom line is it's watermarked, and at some point, if I end up using this, I want to know where it came from. Now, one clip, not so much, but what if I got, like, you know, 20, 30 clips, and they all came from different music libraries, right?
Or different stock photo or video libraries.
Exactly. So there's that clip, and I'm going to select it and press Command-C. Notice I just copied the URL.
You copied the URL.
Right.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to go back to Final Cut Pro, and I'm going to open the timeline index, Command-Shift-2, and I'm parked right over the clip, and so that the timeline index knows that that's the clip, right?
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to double click in the notes field, and you asked me, why did I make this index so big? Well, here's why. Because I can now paste that URL right in the timeline index.
Okay, so it's not so much a matter of which stock company to get this clip from, but what is the specific URL for that clip? Because you know you came from Pond5, but you're like, I have no idea which one, and I didn't write down a little long URL or the number to search by.
I didn't want to.
That's great.
It is fantastic.
I have completely run into that issue of then trying to track down the specific clip from whoever I was buying it from.
Yeah. In fact, now all you need to do is control click and just use open URL right from the menu.
Right there.
And then
not even copy paste it.
Look at that.
That's excellent.
Isn't that
excellent?
That's a
great idea.
Yeah.
So it's more metadata.
It's more metadata.
It's another metadata tip.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
In fact, you can do it with music too. This only take 30 seconds to show, but if I go back into Final Cut and I have another timeline, I had this little commercial I was working on, and I didn't know, you know, you could see I have a audition clip, and I didn't know what music I wanted to use. And this is typical. I'll put a lot of music tracks into an audition container, and then I'll play them back and say, which one do I like? So, and this is kind of more like upbeat, bouncy jazz. And then notice I have the URL already pasted in there for that. And if I switch to that other track, I have, because it noticed the URL changes, because in the timeline index, it's a different clip. So I went from Audio Jungle, which is one music library, and when I switch it, you'll notice it's Premium Beat.
So it just switches when you change auditions, that particularly line in the timeline index updates to reflect.
And I like Premium Beat. A lot of people ask us where we get music. Yeah. This is my chance to say, here's one of the places we get music. I know you use Premium Beat.
I do.
Premium Beat's got some, you know, they get a pretty big website.
Stuff.
And I've used them, I've used Envato, but I like Premium Beat. And so now if I go out to, again, control click, I can open the URL.
Look,
it takes me right to that piece of music.
Mentioning Premium, it's one of the things is you would think when you download comps from these websites that the file name that they give it would allow you to trace back to the file, but they often don't. The file names often, you rename them, or they don't give you a descriptive file name that allows you to find the darn thing.
That's right.
So this is hugely helpful.
I think it's fantastic. In fact, there's probably more stuff that you could probably do it. Like, let's say you're doing an info, some documentary, some infographic, and you're using a graphic that's using Wikipedia as the source. Uh-huh. I don't remember where I got that info. You can like paste the Wikipedia
or right in there.
Who you want to credit or yeah, the source, where the source come from. Yeah. It can be used in a lot of different ways.
Yeah, beautiful. So Steve, awesome tip. Loved it. Super useful. I will use that immediately. So thank you. And thank you, Anders. Thank you guys for watching MacBreak Studio. Check us out at rippletraining.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us at Ripple Training to keep up with everything we're doing. A lot of free tutorials every week, including MacBreak Studio and our Under 5 series that we come out with every Tuesday. So thank you again for watching MacBreak Studio.